Okay, so
here we are.
Yeah, we are.
I'm gonna give you some tools.
Okay.
There you go.
Okay.
Mister.
What do I do?
I'm gonna pour some paint and you're gonna evenly.
Should I go like this and then like this and then like this?
Yeah, really lightly because you don't want to drag all the paint off.
Okay.
Just to spread it out. The other thing we can do is tilt it too. Either way. Here we go. It's kind of a gold.
Just start from the center? Or
it doesn't. It doesn't. Okay. No, it's too hard. Yeah. Just lightly. Don't press down. Yeah, there you go. Just keep doing it. Yeah, don't bring it over the edge yet. Until you get off. You got it. There you go. And then what you do is you go any kind of design. The more curves, the better. I don't have enough chain. You let it sit there for a while and then pull it.
Oh, that's cool.
And I just pull it all the way down. And just stick it in this cup of water. Leave it a bit hanging out. And you can go the opposite direction if you
want. No, like we're making a garden.
A garden.
Why is it moving so much?
Because you're hatching. Just let it hit the... There you go. It's alright. Yeah, you don't have to do a full circle. Just go back and forth like that all the way down. And just pull it straight. Isn't that cool?
That is cool.
Alright, let's do some blue.
Wow, that's really cool.
Isn't that cool?
There you go. So what do I do with this chain?
Put it in the cup. Yeah, I recommend doing that. So, I'll do it. And they don't have to be perfectly straight. You can turn them around. And you can put it right on your put it right here on the lower half of your black as well.
Sorry with this camera in the way.
Just put it down. You like the big lighting. Lift up a little edge. There you go. Can't. Ah! Glare. I'll turn that off.
Oh wow, that's way better.
Looks like it moved a little. Somebody. Just a simple chain.
Pretty cool.
You can do the same thing with string. It's a little bit different. The chain has distinctive features in it. I hate when I do that. Watch this.
Oh, that was ugly.
You didn't pull it straight. That's alright. Put some blue in there.
There's only happy mistakes.
What if you just do it a second time?
You can. Try it. It can't hurt. See, if you lift up like this, you can kind of dictate how it's going to go.
I'll do it slower. That's cool. You got a little more range than I do over there.
You want to come over here?
I might.
The camera's in my way. Well, that's just my excuse.
I'm gonna fix it. You got to fix that. He fixed it. I can fix it. It's kind of cool in there with the blue and yellow. So the other thing you can do is,
a lot of the flowers I do, you can do it like this. And where's the blue? Yeah, kitchen. And you run it on the back side. Or maybe even off the front. It's not yellow. Then pull it. And see how it pulls? It kind of leaves like what's a blossom or a bloom or something like that.
That was cool.
Nice! And look up as you come up in the tree.
That's my favorite one.
All right, here we go. Don't pull down below.
Look what you did to me. I'm sorry.
Yeah, that's why you need to watch it and keep it as you pull. You want to keep it out of the canvas. That's okay.
Still cool.
We'll fix it.
So right where?
I don't know. Like
okay, right here.
Yeah.
Yeah, you don't want to drag it low. That's cool. Wow, that's really
cool. Good one, Dad. You saved it.
Okay, either one. Okay,
I like it because it's got the dark, so we're getting like really nice detail.
Yeah, because of that black that was underneath.
Alright. Okay. What do I do? Start in the yellow, but go down. I would start right here, and but go down. Back and forth down the middle of that black one. There you go. And just watch where your chain's going to be. Cool. Nice! Look at the little buds out.
That's cool.
This guy's really growing. Should we do...
I think something needs to happen right here.
Okay.
I don't know what color.
I'll do the same thing as...
You want white? Yeah, white.
More paint you have on it, the higher you kind of want to lift it up so the paint doesn't puddle.
Now what?
I like this white. That was a good
white's
idea.
Good, yeah.
All right, here we go.
Uh-oh, I don't have a cup.
Here we go. Okay. I think we're needing that one. Did you want to do one red
or something. Somebody dragged something there.
Okay, we need to fix that one.
Or the yellow.
White needs to go
It looks
to go
like
right
the
there.
Yellow's kind of bleeding.
I think
over.
We do a little white one right there. And then I think if you're going to do like a red one, do it like right here.
Okay. Get some, do you want dark red or light red? This is really light.
I would do red, red.
The very dark one?
Yeah. It's got to be. We're going to do one.
Dried out?
You can hold it.
He's like, I'm gonna do a.
That was a cool one.
Yeah, that one is cool.
I'm gonna do a cyanotype. Workshop with my kids.
What's cyan?
Cyanotype is it's like a blue
is
paint
it?
That
cyan.
You. Cyanotype.
Oh, it's C-Y-A-N?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a blue pigment that is photosensitive.
Oh, really?
So you can paint on any surface, canvas, or, cloth or anything.
Uh-huh.
And then you can put objects on it, leaves, negatives, anything you want, and then you expose it to the sunlight, and it leaves an imprint.
Get up on top of it, so then only the parts that have the sand type of image come through. I don't know if that works.
I have no idea. To your left. We should go out the door. Yep.
Yeah. Might have been better if it was brighter. Maybe it needs to do, then do a white over it. Almost like try to do the same thing that you just did, but then put a white highlight. We do! Our first collaborative painting.
It kind of blended with all
right. That's kind of cool. That's
good. All right.
You think it's done?
I don't know. What do you think?
Yeah.
I can paint yellow over there.
Okay.
Get rid of that. And over here.
How do you do that?